Let's see how to set up a development environment for Flask on Ubuntu. Let's start by opening our terminal and installing Visual Studio Code. There are many ways to do that. I just use snap. I now create a folder for my Python project. And in this new folder, I'll create a folder for our Flask tutorial. And let's open this folder in Visual Studio Code. Let's open the built-in terminal by clicking on Terminal and New Terminal. We should already have Python installed on our system. To check which version of Python we have installed, we can run Python 3--version. And on my system, I have Python 3.10.12. But chances are that unless you have already installed pip on your system, you don't have it installed. So if I'll try to check which version of pip I have installed, I can see that I don't have pip installed on my system. So let's go ahead and install it. I'll start by updating my package list. And now I can install pip. To be able to create Python virtual environments, we have to install the venv module. And now that we have it installed, let's create a new Python virtual environment for our project. You can use any name you want. I'll just call mine Flask Env. And if we look at our folder tree, we can see that we now have a new folder named after our virtual environment. In this folder, we have a subfolder called bin. And in the bin folder, we have a script called activate. Let's use the source command to use the activate script. And we can now see the name of the virtual environment written in parentheses at the beginning of the line. This is our indication that we're now running in the context of this virtual environment. So now that that's done, let's install Flask in our new virtual environment. To do that, we simply run pip install Flask. Let's now open our web browser. And if we open the Flask website, we can see under Quick Start a minimal application. Here we can find a very minimal Flask application that we can use for testing. So let's copy the code. And I'll paste it into a file called hello.py. Make sure that you don't create the file inside the folder of the virtual environment, but in the root folder of your project. Visual Studio Code recommends to install the Python extension, so let's accept the recommendation and install it. And let's get back to our file and save it. To start our Flask application, we can use a script that was installed in our virtual environment folder. So if we open the folder of the virtual environment and then the bin subfolder, we can see that we now have here a script called Flask. This is the file we're going to use. And then we need to specify the Flask application we want to run. So --app, and in my case, the application is called hello, so hello, run. And we got a link. So let's press on the control key, then follow the link. And if we get back to our web browser, we can see the response from our Flask development server.